Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss the questions of PT1 examination of, and we will discuss only chemistry portion first of section A, MCQ questions. So let us begin. So the first question is, arrange the following substances in the increasing order of diffusibility. And the statements are iron bar, oxygen gas, and water. And the options are, you have to, in the question, you have to arrange in increasing order. So, and the options are option A, iron bar less than oxygen gas less than water. Second option, oxygen gas less than water less than iron bar. Third option, iron bar less than water less than oxygen gas. And the fourth one, cannot say. So it's a very simple question, students. All of you are knowing about what is diffusion. It is the intermixing of particles of two different types of matter on their own. And I hope all of you have done this correct. So the correct option is iron bar less than water less than oxygen gas. Why? Because we are knowing that the rate of diffusion is maximum in gases, and then in liquid, and then in solid. And here oxygen gas is in gaseous state, and water is in liquid state, and iron bar is in solid state. So the rate of diffusion is maximum in oxygen gas, then water, then iron bar, because it is in solid state, iron bar. So I hope this is clear to all of you. So let us move further towards the next question. So the question is, you have to imagine a situation where particles of matter could speak to each other. So just imagine that situation. So which of the following conversation would never happen? Means which of these options which are given to you is incorrect. So the first option is, one particle is saying to another one that we have some space between us. The second option, we both attract each other. The third option, we are always still, never moving. And the last one is, we constitute all matter around you. So these are the four statements which have already been taken place between the two particles. So you have to select out of these four which one is incorrect. And it's very simple, student. So the correct option is C, means this is the option which is not the one of the characteristics of particles of matter, because we are knowing that particles of matter are continuously moving. They are having kinetic energy, so that's why they are always in random motion. They are continuously moving and vibrating, with colliding with each other. So that's why option C is incorrect, but the answer is option C, because in the question you have been asked that which of the following conversation would never happen, means the third conversation will never happen, because we are knowing characteristics of particles of matter. So this is option C. Moving towards the third question. The question is, suppose all the circles seen in the figure are particles, then which of the following processes is most likely being shown in the figure? Just see the figure over here, and you have to suppose that all these circles which have been given to you are the particles. So you have to tell out of these three options which one is correct. So the first option is burning of incense stick. Second option is cooling of water. And the third option is, can be both option A and B. So you can see just over here, the first option is about burning, and the second option is about cooling. So you are knowing that the correct answer is option A, burning of incense stick, the figure representing burning process. Why? Because in the previously just you have seen that, you are able to see in the picture as well, the particles are very present in very compact manner. After that, the particles are having spaces inside them. They are having intermolecular spaces. So that's why this process is burning. Means with increase in temperature, the particles are gaining kinetic energy, and with increase in the kinetic energy of the particles, those are moving, start moving with more speed, moving, start vibrating more rapidly. and then they are farther apart from each other. That's why the spaces between the particles increase. So this process is known as burning, not cooling. So that's why option A is correct. Further towards the next question. The question is, you filled a glass with water. Then you poured this water into another glass of different shape and size without spilling it. Now the question is, what happens to the mass of the water when this transfer takes place? And the options are, it decreases by a large amount, it increases by a large amount, it remains the same, and the last one is none of the above. So it's a very simple question, and the correct answer is option C, it remains the same. Why? Because we are knowing that about the characteristics of liquid state of matter. So we are knowing that liquids have fixed mass and volume, but they are not having the fixed shape. It is taking the shape of the container in which it is kept. So that's why the mass of the water remains the same. So I hope it's clear to all of you. Moving further towards the next question. So the question is, what happens to the particles, say solid, constituting the matter when heat is supplied to them? And the options are, they lose kinetic energy, they gain kinetic energy, they come very close to each other, and the particles cease to exist. So the options you have properly understood, and the question is, what happens to the particles constituting the matter when heat is supplied to them? Just now we had discussed that when heat is supplied to the particles, what is happening? The particles are gaining kinetic energy. And as the particles are gaining kinetic energy, so they start moving more randomly, more rapidly. So with this increase in the motion, their state changes. So first of all, only we have been asked what happens when heat is supplied to them. Obviously, the correct option over here is they gain kinetic energy, because we are knowing with the giving of external heat, the particles are gaining kinetic energy. That's why option B is correct. Further towards the next question, and the question is, when your mother cooks in the kitchen, you often see steam coming out of the cooking vessels. Which of the following will happen when water in the pan converts into steam? So I hope question is clear to all of you. So here there is conversion of liquid water into vapor. So what this process is known as? The conversion of liquid to vapor is vaporization or evaporation. So, and the options are, particles move further apart, particles come closer, there is no change. So the correct option is option A, particles move further apart, because just now we have discussed as well, when there is state conversion from solid to liquid or from liquid to gases, the state conversion will take place when we are supplying heat to them. And if we are supplying heat to, suppose if we are supplying heat to liquid, then the particles which are present in the liquid, they are gaining kinetic energy, and after gaining kinetic energy, they start moving more random, more rapidly, more faster. And as the rate, their vibrational rate is even more faster, then a time will come, then it is converting its to, it is changing its state, means liquid is converting into vapor. So that's why, and as the liquid is converting into vapor, then we are knowing that the particles are farther apart from each other as compared to liquid state, because we are knowing that the intermolecular spaces in liquid state is less than that of gaseous state. So that's why option A is correct. So moving further towards the next question. In a cylindrical container, air was pressed using a piston and temperature was also decreased. So soon air was converted to a liquid. So what must have happened? The statement one is, pressing the gas so much must have reduced separation between the particles. Second one, lowering the temperature must have increased the energy of the particles. And the third one, lowering the temperature must have decreased the energy of the particles. So these are the three statements. So you have to select what would have happened. So the options are only two, only three, both only one and three. And the last option is all three are possible. So what you all have done? So the correct option is option C, only one and three. Why? Here is the case. This process is known as, if in a cylinder air was pressed using the piston and the temperature was also decreased, means reduced, then it is converting into liquid state. As we had already discussed, this process is known as liquefaction of gases. You must have seen in LPG cylinder, the gases are compressed under high pressure and low temperature. That's what is placed in liquid state. So this process is known as liquefaction of gases. That's why for liquefaction of gases, the favorable conditions are increasing the pressure, means compressing the gas, and lowering down the temperature. And lowering down the temperature is responsible for the decreasing the energy of the particles. So that's why option C is correct. So further towards the next question. Questions are below. You can see a change of state of water. Just see the diagram. You have to choose the option with correct name of the process of conversion. So it's a very simple question. From solid to liquid, X process. And X process must be melting, obviously, because it is converting from solid to liquid. And the reverse process should be solidification. So that's why option C is correct. X process is melting, Y is solidification. It's a very simple question. Moving further towards the next question about naphthalene balls are kept with woolen clothes, disappeared in very short time without any traces of liquid. So what state change takes place with solid naphthalene balls? So you must be knowing about naphthalene balls. Those are the moth balls of chemicals. So you are knowing that naphthalene balls are sublimable substances. Sublimable substances means those substances which directly converting from solid to gaseous without going to its intermediate state, that is liquid state. That's why naphthalene balls are directly disappearing. If you are keeping those naphthalene balls in woolen clothes after some time. So the correct option over here should be option D, sublimation. Why this option is correct? Just now I told you it is the process of direct conversion from solid to gases without going to its intermediate state, that is liquid state. Moving further towards the last question, and the question is, ice at 0 degree Celsius is getting converted to water at 0 degree Celsius. So in which of the two states do the particles have more kinetic energy? Again, it's a very simple question, and the options are particles in ice, particles in water, particles have same kinetic energy in both the states, and the last option is can't be compared. So obviously the correct answer is option B, particles in water. Why? Because we are knowing that ice and water, both are, one is solid state and another one is liquid state, and both are at 0 degree Celsius. So as the characteristics of states of matter, we are knowing that liquid state, the particles having more kinetic energy as compared to solid state. So simply we can say over here that particles in water at 0 degree Celsius having more kinetic energy than particles at 0 degree Celsius of ice, in ice. So I hope all these questions are clear to you. So thank you, students. Stay home, remain safe. Thank you.